Welcome to Tales of Honor Podcast, a podcast dedicated to telling the true stories of every recipient of the Medal of Honor. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Tales of Honor Podcast, the only podcast dedicated to telling the true stories of every single Medal of Honor recipient. I'm your host, Christoph Ambrosch, and today's episode is episode number 258 and takes place during World War II. And now, a tale of honor. On the 25th of June, 1916, Thomas was born in Troy, New York, where he would later enlist in the U.S. Army in October of 1940 at the age of 24. He was a private when he deployed with the 105th Infantry Regiment, 27th Infantry Division to the Marianas Island, and it was his actions there that would earn him the Medal of Honor. The citation reads, "For conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty, at Saipan, the Mariana Islands, 19 June to 7 July 1944, when his entire company was held up by fire from automatic weapons and small arms fire from strongly fortified enemy positions that commanded the view of the company, Sergeant, then Private, Baker voluntarily took a bazooka and dashed alone to within 100 yards of the enemy. Through heavy rifle and machine gun fire that was directed at him by the enemy, he knocked out the strong point, enabling his company to assault the ridge. Some days later, while his company advanced across the open field flanked with obstructions and places of concealment for the enemy, Sergeant Baker again voluntarily took up a position in the rear to protect the company against a surprise attack and came upon two heavily fortified enemy pockets manned by two officers and 10 enlisted men which had been bypassed. Without regard for such superior numbers, he unhesitatingly attacked and killed all of them. 500 yards further, he discovered 6 men of the enemy who had concealed themselves behind our lines and destroyed all of them. On 7 July 1944, the perimeter of which Sergeant Baker was a part was attacked from 3 sides by from 3,000 to 5,000 Japanese. During the early stages of this attack, Sergeant Baker was severely wounded, but he insisted on remaining in the line and fired at the enemy at ranges sometimes as close as 5 yards until his ammunition ran out. Without ammunition and with his weapon battered to uselessness from hand-to-hand combat, he was carried about 50 yards to the rear by a comrade who was then himself wounded. At this point, Sergeant Baker refused to be moved any further, stating that he preferred to be left to die rather than risk the lives of any more of his friends. A short time later, at his request, he was placed in a sitting position against a small tree. Another comrade, withdrawing, offered assistance. Sergeant Baker refused, insisting that he be left alone and be given a soldier's pistol with its remaining 8 rounds of ammunition. When last seen alive, Sergeant Baker was propped against a tree, pistol in hand, calmly facing the foe. Later, Sergeant Baker's body was found in the same position, gun empty, with 8 Japanese lying dead before him. His deeds were in keeping with the highest traditions of the U.S. Army. Thomas was posthumously promoted to the rank of sergeant and received the Medal of Honor. Thomas Alexander Baker is buried in the Gerald G. H. Solomon Saratoga National Cemetery in Schuylerville, New York, Section F, Grave 162. And that was a tale of honor. Thank you for listening to Tales of Honor Podcast. Head on over to talesofhonorpodcast.com, where you can read these stories, see other ways to support the show, and easily share a story with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, you can send them to talesofhonorpodcast@gmail.com. And until next time, I'm Christoph Ambrosch. Thanks for listening.